The world is in such a turbulent and rapid global transformation. And in this time, in this process of change, there are two lines that are more and more coming together. One is the political line for the necessary system change in the economic, political, social ways. And the other is the spiritual line, the work for reconnecting with source, with essence, with that sacred core from which we all come and in which we are all connected. And it is part of this very transformation operating through humanity and through the whole planet that these two lines more and more come together, two lines that have hardly been together, at least not in the paradigms of this patriarchal capitalist world. And when they come together, a new form of political action emerges, one that is no longer grounded in hatred or in the mere no to what creates injustice or war, but it is this place of honoring the sacredness of all beings and of being in the deepest sense of service that we can be to living beings, because all beings are sacred. And we have called this gathering because we were deeply moved by how this movement is emerging in the world, how these two lines come together in more and more places, and for how example, in Standing Rock, in this resistance against the Dakota Access Pipeline, led by courageous indigenous water protectors, not only an unprecedented alliance came together of so many First Nation people, but also of people from all different political camps, but where this resistance really sent a message to humanity, a calling for humanity to wake up and to remember that this earth is not just dead matter ready for us to be exploited, but is a living organism, and that we as humanity are one organ in this living, sentient being, and that our own survival as humanity relies on us to remember this inherent interdependence and to honor it again and to create a new world that is in right relation. I thank this movement of Standing Rock. I'm happy that Tocata is here, that La Donna, I don't know if she's in the room already, but that those leaders are joining us now. And we called this gathering together because we saw, or we felt, that this movement, even though the fight against the Dakota Access Pipeline might for now be lost, or maybe not, but because what started there has the potential to turn into a planetary movement, a movement for defending the sacred everywhere, a movement of conscious human beings that take care for life again, guided by the spirit of community, by the ethics of universal solidarity and cooperation, and the movement creating more and more places that model the future and step out of this system destroying life. And so I also want to say that we called this together because it is not just in Standing Rock where this takes place, but actually in more and more places around the world. We have people here who were leaders in the Sumud Freedom Camp in Palestine that was inspired by Standing Rock, leaders of supporters of Faja, an eco-village, creating an alternative in the West Bank in Palestine. Leaders of the peace community of San Jose de Apartado and indigenous people in the Sierra Nevada de Santa Marta that are creating an alternative to the civil war in Colombia. People from a favela in Brazil that are trying to create a model for how cities can become places in cooperation with nature and places of community. People creating a place called Otepic in Kenya, a permaculture center, showing how in the middle of a situation of famine, people can regain food sovereignty. And many, many, many more such places, which I will not mention because it would take very long, but this is a place to make us aware that in addition to all the destruction on this planet, a planetary community is arising, and that this moment we have the possibility to bring us together and to recognize that when we weave a network and when we become together a planetary organ that listens to this power of life that wants to operate through us like in this choir, we can conceive of a different vision for how humanity inhabits this planet. And we are also here because we need a different way, or we need to find a way, I can say I need to find a way, to respond to the global pain on this planet. I think as somebody, a human being who still has an open heart, has a difficult time in this moment and has to find ways not to collapse in front of this unimaginable pain living beings have to suffer. It is beyond our imagination what is happening on this planet. The whole world seems to be at fire. It seems as if there are a million crises everywhere that we need to attend separately. And yet, actually, it is just one crisis that we are facing, which is a civilization that is in contradiction with life, that is hardwired to exploit the earth, divide people, torment animals, kill and destroy. And in the face of this, we need a global alliance to come together. So long as we are only defending the sacred locally, regionally, or nationally, we will always be overpowered by a global system which overpowers us simply because it is globally organized. Yet when a global community comes together that does not only know what it is against, what it says no to together, but that it is actually grounded in the sacred, one that develops more and more of a common vision of what an alternative to this system is globally, an alliance that learns to trust deeper and deeper, then we are in a different situation. The dynamics of power change. We actually see that this system that we are fighting, that always seems overpowering when we face it individually, is on its way down, and a new planetary culture wants to be born at this moment. It is really about a shift of power. It's globally, as weird as this may sound, yet it is not only a shift of power from one group to the other, from one ideology to the other, but from one principle of power to another one, from one completely different matrix, from one matrix to a completely different one. The old paradigm was the power of force, the power of fear projections playing out. And there is sacred activism, which is a different principle of power, power of resonance, rooted in the sacred space. And in this time, we want to engage not only in talking, but also in an experience of this sacred space. I think after this millennia of separation and war, there might not be a bigger longing than the one for all beings to reunite in sacred space, to come to this point where we recognize that we are identical and one in this sacred space. In this place, we recognize that we are not the roles and characters we played. We are not victims or perpetrators. We are universal beings. And in this sacred space, neither violence, nor fear, nor oppression make any sense. Addressing this sacred core, we can awaken a powerful memory in people's hearts. And we recognize that in addition to the fantasies of downfall that this earth is full of at the moment, actually evolution carries a different direction. The collapse of global capitalism must not result in collective downfall, but in the birth of a new global society in which people live in communities where they honor each other, honor all life, honor the balance of water and fire. And the more we can see this vision, and that it is not just a dream, but part of life, nobody can invent it, it is part of the living world whenever we open up for it. The more we see it, the more we talk about it, the more we create gatherings where it can shine through, we help birth this new era. So I invite the spirit to guide us in this time. May we be of service to the earth. May we listen. May we be channels for the powers of global healing to touch this earth in trust and love. Thank you very much, and welcome to this gathering.